at this point in time, inform you that we have several partners in this room. Forward, backward, lateral linkages are immense in the sector. And so one of our partners this morning is GIZ, the German Technical and Development Cooperation Agency, who is here to share with us on this topic, exploring sustainable approaches of developing oil and gas industry. They've done this elsewhere. They are here in Uganda to give us some kind of technical advice. And so without further ado, Kristin Senteza, you're the project manager E4D at GIZ. Where are you? Come and speak to us. Thank you.
Right. Good morning to you, everyone. My name's Kristin Senteza from the E4D project. That's the Employment and Skills for Development in Africa project. It's a project that is implemented by the German Development Corporation, that's GIZ. I would really like to thank Ms. Penina Hewa for such a rich insight into the regulatory work of the PAU. And I'm sure we are all now confident that you have the interests of SMEs in Uganda at heart while working with the oil and gas sector in Uganda. So to kickstart my brief presentation about our work at GIZ, okay? So the Employment and Skills for Development in Africa program, E4D, has the main objective of promoting employment amongst SMEs in Uganda, and we do this through supporting vast investments in the oil and gas sector and also in other traditional sectors. So we use the oil and gas sector as a catalyst for trickle down effects into other traditional sectors of the economy. We address these challenges through closing skills gaps that enterprises may have, and also through addressing any bottlenecks and challenges that may deter the SMEs from gaining a competitive advantage in such a specialized sector. So E4D at a glance is mainly funded by a wide range of development partners, including the BMZ, that is the German Federal Ministry for Economic Cooperation and Development. We also have the European Union on board. We have the Norwegian Agency for Development Cooperation, that's NORAD, and also funded by a wide range of other stakeholders. So we operate mainly in 6 countries, of which Uganda is inclusive. We have operations in Kenya, Ghana, South Africa, and Mozambique. And our focus sectors are mainly 6: construction, tourism, hospitality, manufacturing, and we have more recently ventured into agribusiness. We have a total volume for Uganda at 20 million euros and are looking at promoting employment to achieve at least 58,000 jobs and have about 190 people with an improved employment situation. So far in Uganda, we've brought for both our phases, the project started in 2015 and shall run until 2023. We've had an achievement of over 7,600 jobs and an improved employment situation for about 39,000 people. So most important to note is that we are a multi-stakeholder organization that we are promoting really employment promotion and creating opportunities for SMEs in the oil and gas industry. So our approach is mainly a 3-pillar approach, whereby we have on one side a demand side for labor, that is enterprise promotion, and this is the deeper insight that I'm going to give today, will be on our enterprise development component and its work in the oil and gas sector. Then we also have another pillar, that is skills development, whereby we look at trainings for individuals, and most certainly and most usually these include international certifications. So in between we have a matching component that matches the demand supply of labor to the supply side of labor, and here we train graduates and job seekers to effectively enter into work placements, internships, and also to get them career ready through our ready to work projects. So we have various projects, so sub projects under all three pillars, but all these demonstrate our commitment and ability as E4D to tackle challenges that SMEs face in entering and also maintaining relations in this oil and gas sector, and also fulfilling and contributing to local content and also national oil and gas policy objectives. Our interventions are based on concrete need and focused demand from the enterprises, and are usually done in partnership and consultation with the various stakeholders and partners that we have. So just to highlight a few projects that we have lined up for the SMEs in Uganda. First of all, we have two health and safety projects. One of them is the ISO 14001, that is Environmental Management Systems. And secondly, the ISO 45001, that is Occupational Health and Safety. These two projects are planned for a total of 75 enterprises. Actually, they have been selected in partnership and consultation with PAU. And they complement previous efforts in NEBOSH training and HSC training that happened in 2018. And both projects shall run until from November this year to June 2022. So both projects were widely publicized on the PAU website and with other partners, for example, industry associations, and I'm sure some of you may have gotten wind of these trainings. And we believe that the fact that most SMEs are faced with challenges of having limited or no standard certifications or standardizations that are usually required by large oil companies, such trainings will go a long way in promoting and enhancing the competitiveness of SMEs, and thus making them able to enter the value chains in the oil and gas sector. So just to explain the objectives of both ISO trainings, for the 45001, we shall ensure that the major objective is to ensure that there are reduced workplace incidents and occupational hazards, while the 14001 shall enable SMEs set up an internal environmental management system and thus increase reputation and also be able to benefit from the other advantages of being ISO certified. In a similar vein, we have lined up a bid and contract management project. We've had two previous phases of this training, phase one and phase two, that we are really addressing challenges in the insufficient information that is prevalent amongst the SMEs. They're not able to obtain information about the kind of procurement procedures and requirements required by the large oil companies. So with the bid management trainings, as one of the previous speakers have said, it supported the SMEs to effectively enter the value chains. We supported them and took them through bidding libraries, whether they could take a bidding or no bid decision. And for the two phases, we trained over 120 enterprises, and an additional 80 enterprises shall be trained in 2022 to bring it to a total of 200 enterprises that shall have benefited from this bid and contract management project. So furthermore, Okay. Another project that we are so proud of is our long-standing partnership with the Stanbic Business Incubator. So with the Stanbic Business Incubator, we are looking at promoting the capacities of small and medium enterprises. This is a nationwide approach that is delivered through different regional hubs in Uganda. SMEs are supported with various topics such as business development, planning, inventory management, to mention but a few. And through this partnership with the Business Stanbic Incubator, we've had lots of results that I'm sure the team from the Stanbic Incubator was so proud to present in the previous days. We have a current running partnership that shall see more enterprises promoted and supported to meaningfully benefit from the new opportunities and that have been presented by the oil and gas sector, the emerging sector. So just in addition, we have another project. This is new, and here I would urge the various enterprises to look out for it and to be able to take advantage of the opportunities presented by the Ethos project. This project is aimed at enhancing the competitiveness of small and medium enterprises in Uganda. It shall be looking at supporting 1,000 SMEs and shall run for a period of 2 years, from November this year to November 2023. So within this project, we shall have each enterprise undergo a comprehensive business diagnostic and also obtain support in training through international certifications and get support on marketing, quality enhancement measures, because we all realize that exploiting opportunities within this sector remains a challenge, as SMEs are still fragmented, they are run by sole proprietors, having issues with meeting and delivering high quality goods and products as may be required by the oil companies. So this is also lined up for you. And last but not least, since the oil and gas sector is highly specialized and requires huge capital investments, we have through an additional project that is financing SMEs through small grants, come set up a COVID response project to support SMEs in their economic recovery to ensure that they thrive today and also are able to have business continuity in the future. So this project aims at awarding a total sum of 15,000 euro per enterprise. We've so far received a number of proposals from SMEs that have trained with us in the past, and welcomed innovative proposals such as those looking at waste management and recycling, and also LEED certification for international green building standards. This is offered in partnership with two other GIZ projects, that's the Business Scouts for Development and the Nature's Project. Yeah, so last but not least, again, we as IFOD have also commissioned two studies. One of them is the capacity needs assessment that is being conducted in partnership with the Ministry of Energy and Mineral Development and the Ministry of Education, plus the PAU, and the rapid skills assessment that is done in partnership with the ILO, International Labour Organization. Both studies aim at identifying the labor shortages and demand, mostly arising from the COVID-19 situation, such that we can support further reskilling or upskilling of the available skills on the market. Both studies shall be launched soon and shall inform national communication and sensitization campaigns for the oil and for any upcoming plans or developments in the oil and gas industry. So some of the achievements that we've been able to achieve as IFOD include the fact that we've supported, since our first phase that we commenced in 2015, We've been able to support over 10,000 enterprises across the 6 sectors in Uganda. Over 20,000 women and youth have been trained, and 7,600 jobs have been achieved in phase one. And in phase two, we hope to achieve an additional 5,000 jobs. So, ladies and gentlemen, that brings me to the end of my presentation. Once again, I would like to thank the Stanbic Business Incubator Limited for organizing this conference and for inviting us to make a brief pitch to you about what we have in stock for you. And I bring you warm regards from our team leader, also Mr. Donald Agaba, who was unfortunately unable to attend. And I look forward to a fruitful discussion and interaction with you in the afternoon. Thank you so much.